Good morning, students. I hope you all are well and doing online study. Today we will do English grammar. In previous video, we learnt about finite and non-finite verbs. Let's take a quick recap. Example of finite verbs. First sentence, I like ice cream. In this sentence, like is finite verb. And this is used according to plural subject. He likes ice cream. In this sentence, likes is finite verb and this is used according to singular subject. Example of non-finite verbs. I like to eat ice cream. In this sentence, two verbs are there. First one is like and next one is eat. But like is finite verb and to eat is non-finite verb. Finite verb always used according to the subject. When the subject is plural, we will not add s and es in verb. And when the subject is singular, we have to add s and es in the verb. In next sentence, he likes to eat ice cream. In this sentence, likes is finite verb and to eat is non-finite verb. In both the sentences, to eat is non-finite verb and these verbs are remains the same. There are three types of non-finite verbs: infinitives, gerunds, participle. Let's see what are the infinitives. Read the sentences. We went to watch the film. In this sentence, to watch is non-finite verb and this is an infinitive. I would like to learn dance. In this sentence, to learn is non-finite verb and this is an infinitive. The match is about to start. In this sentence, to start is non-finite verb and this is an infinitive. I wish to see her. In this sentence, to see is non-finite verb and this is an infinitive. Okay, all the underlined words are infinitives. These verbs are not bound, limits of person and number. In other words, we can say these verbs are infinite, so they are known as infinitive. Infinitives are such verbs which are used along with to. Let's see the definition of infinitives. A verb is said to be an infinitive when it is not bound by limits of person, number of any noun. Next is gerunds. Let's learn about gerunds. Read the sentences. Swimming is a good exercise. Sleeping is necessary for health. Gardening is a good hobby. Walking is good for health. In all the sentences, the underlying words are ing verbs, but they behave as verbal noun. Definition of gerunds. A gerund is a noun formed from a verb by adding ing. It is a verbal noun. Let's see the uses of the gerund. A gerund can be used as subject of a verb. It can be used as a subject. Swimming is a good exercise. Gardening is a good hobby. In both the sentences, swimming and gardening both are subject. Object of a verb. Stop talking at once. Stop talking at once. In this sentence, stop is finite verb, talking is non-finite verb and talking is object of a verb. Talking is object of a verb and talking is gerund. He is not good at reading or writing. In this sentence, is finite verb and reading or writing are non-finite verbs and they both are behaving as a object of a verb. These are gerund. Object of a preposition. I am tired of waiting. I am tired of waiting. Children are very fond of playing. In both the sentences, what is preposition? Yes, of is preposition and waiting is object of a preposition. It is gerund. Children are very fond of playing. In this sentence, of is preposition and playing is non-finite verb and it is also behaving as object of a preposition. So, playing is also a gerund. Complement of a verb. Seeing is believing. Seeing is believing. What he needs is a beating. In both the sentences, believing and beating, they are complement of a verb. A prohibition. No smoking, no parking here. In both the sentences, smoking and parking both are gerund. Now next is participles. What are the participles? A participle is a verb form that can be used as an adjective to create verb tense or to create the passive voice. There are two types of participles. Present participles ending with ing, past participles usually ending ed, d, t, en or n. Let's see the examples of the participle. Read the following sentences. You are playing a losing game. You are playing a losing game. In this sentence, losing is non-finite verb and this behave as an adjective and followed by noun. What is noun? Game. Barking dogs seldom bite. In this sentence, barking is non-finite verb. This behave as an adjective and followed by noun. What is noun? Dogs. And losing and barking both are present participle. There are two types of participles, present participle and past participles. The faded flowers were thrown away. In this sentence, faded is past participle. This is non-finite verb. This behave as an adjective and followed by nouns. What is noun? Flowers. His broken leg was plastered. His broken leg was plastered. In this sentence also, broken is past participle. Buddha took pity on the wounded swan. In this sentence, wounded is past participle. Now we will do exercise. Underline the gerund in each sentence. I love reading novels. Yes, children. One thing, when we get the answer of what? I love reading novels. So what I love? Reading novels. We are getting an answer of what? So reading is gerund. Playing cards is a bad habit. So what is a bad habit? Playing cards. So we are getting an answer of what? Playing is gerund. It is no use of crying over the spilt milk. What is the no use of crying? Crying is gerund. It is no good learning by rote. So in this sentence, learning is gerund. Borrowing is begging. What is begging? Borrowing is begging. So borrowing is gerund. She likes running a race daily. So what does she like? Running a race. So running is gerund. Drinking has ruined his health. What ruined his health? Drinking. So drinking is gerund. You must avoid mixing with bad boys. So what should you avoid? Mixing with bad boys. So mixing is gerund. Another exercise. The new law forbids cutting off trees. The new law forbids cutting off trees. In this sentence, cutting is non-finite verb and off is preposition. So cutting is gerund. Smoking is prohibited here. Smoking is gerund. To see is to believe. To see is infinitive. We saw him stealing your money. Stealing is gerund. Jitu loves to play cricket. Jitu loves to play cricket. In this sentence, to play is an infinitive. They decided to go on a picnic. So, to go is infinitive. Gambling is a bad habit. What is a bad habit? Gambling. So gambling is a gerund. Have you heard the story of the dancing wolves? So in this sentence, dancing is, yes, participle, and this is present participle. Present participle, it behaves as an adjective and followed by noun. What is noun? Wolves. Next exercise, fill in the blanks with a suitable gerund. He is an expert in, you can write anything. You can write dancing, singing, writing. Next is, he left the hotel without dash his bill. What will come? Yes, without paying his bill. We prevented him from sinking into deep water. He succeeded in getting first division. Talking between the meals is a bad habit. My friend does not like gossiping. Flowers is strictly prohibited. So what can come here? Yes, plucking flowers. Yes, this pen is not worth dash at all. Writing at all. I hope you all have understood this lesson. Now one more exercise is there. Underline the participle in the following sentences and write whether they are present participle or past participle. The broken vase was very expensive. In this sentence, broken vase. Yes, broken is non-finite verb and this is an adjective and vase is noun. So broken is past participle. I saw him stealing a ring. Yes, I saw him stealing a ring. Stealing is present participle. Broken is past participle. In this sentence, a ring is noun. Hearing the noise, the boy woke up. In this sentence, hearing is present participle. These were the last words of the dying man. Yes, dying man. Man is noun and it is followed by noun. Dying is present participle. This is a winning essay. Winning is present participle. The lumberman cut the fallen tree into logs. Fallen is past participle. The withered flowers were thrown away. Yes, thrown. Withered is past participle. It is a bed to kiss a sleeping child. Sleeping is present participle. The teacher found the pupil dozing. So dozing is, the teacher found the pupil dozing. Yes, what is the participle in this sentence? Found. Found is past participle. All living creatures breathe in air. Living is present participle. I hope you all have understood the lesson. Do practice at home. Solve the exercise. Sairam. Thank you, children.